Hi, my name is Holly and today I'm really excited because I'm going to be making some Kinder Bueno chocolate fudge. Kinder is just my absolute favourite chocolate in the whole wide world, so I'm really excited to be making this and I'm going to take you through the whole process. It's really quick, it probably only takes about 10-15 minutes, so yeah, I'll take you along and show you what I did. So here's all my ingredients laid out. And here is the list of ingredients and the amounts you need. Firstly, I set up my scales and I grabbed my icing sugar and I just poured that out, measuring the 75 grams that you need. And then I just set that aside, put away the scales and grabbed my bowl and I started breaking up the Kinder chocolate, which took an absolute age. There was, I think, 20 bars or something ridiculous like that, as well as the dairy milk. So I've just tried to speed this up a little bit, but there is a lot to unwrap and try not to eat any, even though the smell of it is just divine. I took all of the broken up pieces of chocolate, I placed it on some water that I had heating on the hob, so just set that down. Then I grabbed my spatula and had a little mix around. Now this will take a while to melt, it is a massive load of chocolate. So while that was melting, I just went back over to the counter and started breaking up the Kinder Bueno pieces. Sure to go back and check the chocolate that was melting on the hob. Yeah, don't worry about the steam or anything, that is supposed to happen. So I'm just giving it a little mix around, make sure it's melting all the way through. This is what it looks like at the moment. And so I continued to let that melt and I went over to my tray that I have set out for this. I grabbed my baking parchment paper, just sort of measured it out roughly, it doesn't have to be perfect, and then cut it to size. Then I just haphazardly shoved that in, tried to crunch it around as best I could, used the condensed milk can to sort of weigh it down while I tried to make sure that it fit the tin properly. Obviously it doesn't have to be perfect. Now back to the melted chocolate, just kept stirring that, making sure that there was no lumps. So here you can see there are still some lumps that needed a little bit more time still on the hob. And once that was fully melted, I poured in the condensed milk and there goes the lid. Please don't be as foolish as I am. Take the lid out before you start pouring the condensed milk. Here I am, I took it off the heat while I mixed in the condensed milk just so it was a bit easier. Also, don't worry about the bowl slipping, that will happen. Just try and hold on to it as best you can while you're trying to mix. Then I grabbed the icing sugar that we set aside. I put in about half of it at first so that I could smoothly try and mix that in. I've put it back on the heat now because the chocolate was starting to firm up and you don't want that just yet. I would also recommend that I probably should have sieved the icing sugar in rather than just pouring it in, as there's quite a few lumps and you will see this come later. And also, yeah, don't be a fool like I was again and I spilled the icing sugar over the side. Be much more gentle than I was. So here it is all mixed in. As you can see, there are some little lumps, but I wasn't too worried about that. There wasn't really anything I could do because I'd already poured it in non-sieved. And then I just took the bowl off of the heat and put it to the side. And remember to just keep mixing as the chocolate will be trying to firm up as quickly as possible. So here I am just giving it a quick mix and now I'm grabbing my Kinder Bueno pieces and pouring them in and then I'm folding those into the mixture with my spatula. I've deliberately left a couple on the side so that I can place those on top. But for now, I just poured that into my baking tray that I'd set aside. This was actually quite difficult to do on my own. The bowl was hot. So here you can see me trying and not very successfully pouring it in. After the camera cuts off, I actually got my mum to come and help me. She held the bowl while we scraped out the rest of it. Yep, here I am getting my mum. And here it is with her help. So now I'm just placing on the Kinder Bueno pieces to the top of it. That's what it looks like. And now I'm just placing it in the fridge to let it set. So after I'd let it set for a few hours, I took it out of the fridge and placed it on the side to begin chopping it up into little sections. So I initially tried to cut it up into 9 pieces because I live with my mum and dad, so I thought that would be enough for sort of 3 desserts, but upon trying to eat one of these massive chunks, you'll see when I pull them out later that I just cut them way too big. They definitely could have been a third of the size that I cut them. I just didn't realize how deep the pan was, so that was a mistake. So I will definitely be going back and cutting these a lot smaller. I also later realized that cutting it in the tin like this was actually really difficult, and later on I take out the parchment paper with the fudge still in it and put it on a flat surface, and it is much easier to cut that way. I don't know why I even tried to do it this way. Look at me struggling, like, this is not, do not do it this way. It was very difficult and annoying. Even on the plate, it is still quite difficult to cut because it's so thick and so sticky, but you just gotta endeavor and put a lot of oomph into it, and obviously you'll figure it out. So here is the final product. As you can see, like I said before, they were definitely too large cut this way, but they were really delicious, so yummy. Yeah, so that's it. This is what they look like, and just thank you for watching.